Back to the conclusive segment here of the RD LMS here for
Le Mans
live series here. 12 hours event here, live streaming to you. My name's Simon Smith. I've been dragging you all, kicking and screaming, regardless of whether you wanted to or not, through this race. And I've not been doing it alone. I've had excellent help here from Joachim Skousted. Roy Magnus.
Good morning.
And now we've also had in and out action from Wayne Reed.
I can't think of anything to say you've sprung that on me.
And we currently also have had slightly barely legal advice from Oscar Hardwick.
Thanks, Vandal.
And we've had
plenty. That's the most miserable tone I've come out with all day. I'm just going to go hang myself. No, I've enjoyed it, I promise.
Emo. We've also had good fun from Esben Tipple.
Someone had to.
And cynical Americanism world domination from Joseph Mudrack.
Pow pow blah blah, I put a massive represent.
And we've had plenty of other people bumpy trotting their way in and out of the commentary box, and we have had a 12 hour race banging on as well, but I do feel that does come second to
David Lowry says Lowest timing shows that Robin Toll's car has pitted twice.
Then it's don't wrong. Worry. Yeah, he's just very very out. Efficient.
So it's an electric car.
No, if it was an electric car, it wouldn't have pitted at all, because it would have gone 17 metres and then had to stop.
No, it wouldn't have stopped, because it's probably a Toyota, so it wouldn't have stopped.
Well, certainly not the car in front, so they never are as advertised, were they, to be fair?
Let's face it, if you did have an electric car, you might have got to when it started getting dark, but if you have to turn the lights on, you're stuffed.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I miss the old Honda adverts.
Yes.
Do you remember those?
Oh, yes.
Before they got smug.
Yeah. Yeah, the cog one and all that lot, that was super.
Yeah.
That was.
Yeah, exactly. So.
I don't know. Thing at the British Motor Show that year as well, they had Benson Button's Honda F1 car suspended off the ceiling in absolute pieces, but it was locked, it was blown up lower ground.
Oh wow!
That was absolutely awesome to see that.
Cool.
Fortunately, they didn't let us touch it. I thought they wouldn't. They wouldn't have missed a wheel nut. They're only what, £2,000 or something.
Well, you can get a couple out.
A bag with a brochure.
Aww. You could have just replaced them with one out of Halfords. It would have been fine.
But I've got a free parking pen at the mini. So.
Aww.
I can give you it if you filled out the paperwork to enter the competition. The arsehole just said to. Of the pen, she went
on. I've got an interesting story.
Ooh.
I like that. Synchronised it all. Back in 2002, I went to the motor show, which was at the Birmingham NEC that year.
Hmm.
And they had a big rally simulator set up, and it was Richard Burns related. I think it might even have been an early alpha of the Richard Burns rally game at the time. And they were doing a big competition, so you could go and sit in it and set a time through a stage, and whoever was the quickest would get a prize, and so on. And the simulators were quite cool, because they had the Peugeot 206 rally cars, and they just fitted them with screens in the windscreen. It was as though you were driving the cars. And I went there at the age of, I think I must have been about 8 at the time, and I came third of everyone on the day.
And I was
there,
was two or something.
And I did the same thing at the Toyota stand, and I knew it was actually our factory with the Toyota F1 car running on it. I'd never discovered it, our factory at this stage. Waited an hour and a half to get on this. Got on there, done a lap time, and then got a letter through the post, and I was 17th fastest in the day, so I was brought up.
Well, hey.
Was hooked. He was watching the other folk on it, because they'd set it up so that it was all like automatic gearing and that, which was a bit pants. But seeing some of them get on there, and well, I think they actually would have been better on Richard Burns Rally, to be honest, the way I was tracking that with one. It is the best place to go. If you can get to one, go to a motor show, because it's, you get there like nothing else.
Has the Robin Dole car got a pit stop to make yet, or are they done for the day?
Toll last pitted on lap 171. So I would say they are okay. But it's close, but it will be okay.
Yeah, okay. I was gonna say if they do have to make another splash, that'll put Steve Davis in contention for that second position.
Yeah. No, he was gonna have
that's
to
the, that's average.
Well, Eddie Helgen has just left the pits as well for ME Racing. So they are ready to go for the rest of the race.
Well, we've got to be in the last 5 or 10 minutes now.
Nope.
The last 20.
Last 20. Wishful thinking. Wishful thinking. We've done so very well. We should all pat ourselves on the back.
I've been in here so long now, Wayne. I feel as though leaving would be wrong.
You're part of the crew now, you, Wayne. You've done well.
It's going to be a case of...
I think all of us should get together for the 24 hours of Nordschleife, and we'll go the full 24 hours.
I was about to say, about when the 24 hours is done, I'll flick on the stream and go, Simon, can I come in the commentary box, please?
And I'll say, oh no, I've rolled over and splattered you because you sound suspiciously like a moose. A moosey mouse.
Anyone watch my read my entry quote for the 24 hours?
No.
I'm going to both drive and commentate at the same time.
Yes, I've read that. But I should definitely be up for the commentary because I've had an absolute blast.
Awesome, and I think
I'm a safer bet in the commentary booth, to be honest, because I don't fancy my chances driving an Aston Martin around Nordschleife. There's just no room for it.
I'm liking Bradley Vanian's suggestion. At the 24 hours drink, we should do a drinking game. Every time someone disconnects, we have to down a pint.
Oh, no, not a Stella. That's
wife beater.
In all fairness, I can't partake in that because I'm underage.
Yeah, no,
that's
you're not.
Okay. We'll give you Ribena.
You're drinking in a public house, drinking indoors at the age of 16 with your parents and sick.
I thought it was 5.
Well, that's because you just started young, you know.
Well, my parents said that actually when I was a little baby, when I used to cry, they used to dip my dummy in whiskey.
Mine was better.
Yeah.
Rohypnol, definitely.
Now, see, I think Rohypnol's better taken by men because you could sleep with some ugly bird and then wake up in the morning and not remember it.
Joachim sounds like you've just poked a memory there.
No, I'm just trying to find the car. There was this yellow car missing its front bumper.
Oh, excitement. Saurus, where is it?
I'm trying to find it.
Kevin Ledoux, 9th.
Yeah, Ledoux.
Look, Bradley's aiming for the orange squash.
We'll give you Ribene with E numbers. Yeah, he's missing his front bumper and he's going quite slowly, is Kevin. In 9th position. He's got 4 laps ahead of Carl Middleton, so he can get in and get repaired and get going if he wants to. But he's going to keep going, even though he straddled that curb. I think he wanted to go to the pits there, to be fair.
He wants to, really. He needs to.
I think he just straddled the curb.
Yeah, I'm trying to find where he went off.
We also have, just while you're finding that out, Alvin Waivers has popped into the booth. Didn't quite go to plan for you, Alvin, because you binned it, but tell us all about it.
Well, yeah, I started my stint, and 2 laps into the stint, I started to get some crazy pit stop requests, and, you know, I started not trying to get the pit stop request, I don't want the pit stop request, trying to get my info screen back to the times that I was doing, and I had a mental lapse and missed my breaking point going into a bunch of curbs, and you know the rest of the story. Into the wall, and the hill, and on the race.
Well, that's a shame, Alvin, but At least you had some fun while you was out there, and it's been an interesting season for yourself, because I've seen you in a few of the races. Will you be back for the 24-hour one?
Well, yeah, then I had a good time with all of you racing, all those races. They gave me the opportunity to race in this Women's Series, and I thank Georgios Navakos for giving me this opportunity. And yes, I will be on the 24 hours of Nürburgring with Waterloo Racing. I'll be racing there too. And, well, let's see what happens.
Yeah, we'll keep our fingers crossed and hope everything goes well. One last slightly off-topic question. Do you own any chipmunks? could you just sing something really, really high-pitched? Just one line of anything, and I promise I will not do that question or that comment ever again.
Ignore Simon.
A bit, man, he's taking your dignity. He had more than hours back.
I tell you what, I've taken a...
I'm gonna win!
Fantastic!
Oh dear! He deserves a trophy for doing that!
Oh, super!
Excellent!
I'm looking forward to this season recap.
I tell you what, if anyone wants to know my highlight of the race, that is it right there, people.
Yeah. That's the funniest moment of the race.
Excellent. Well, you've got to come back for the 24 hours one now.
Yeah, I'm going to come back.
Oh, dear. He sounds like one of the Scrotian brothers, doesn't he?
After they've been in the war.
Yeah. Fiji's impression.
Well, it's good to still have a good humor after.
Yeah.
So, after having doing a very stupid mistake, honestly. Most of our DNFs have been due to technical troubles, disconnections, some stuff like that. The AI mysteriously taking possession of the car, crashing all the other cars, and everybody thinking it was my fault, but, well, at least I clarify that. And, well, this one wasn't any technical, it was a stupid mistake of my part, I know that. But, well, this thing happens, and I hope this doesn't happen again, you know?
Everyone has their updates and their down days, so
you're
I wouldn't worry.
You're human. I've done it today myself and come back here, not actually.
Yeah. You're only human unless you're an alien.
Yeah, that's a good thing. I'm not an alien. I'm not doing stupid fast laps, you know?
Yeah. He wants to be an alien anyway.
Well, you're
right. Because
I've always thought... Being an alien must be really boring because you never actually battle anyone because you're always busy being on your own. So what's the point in that? I remember when I used to commentate before they took me off it, don't know why, I couldn't possibly think, the iRacing stuff. And I've forgotten the name of the guy that won every single race, every single round. That's it. I knew it was something to do with hooting the whole...
Oh, what were you... commentating on it back in the day when the Indy cars ran the Pro Series.
Yeah,
fair enough.
But then they decided that actually they didn't want me or Jack Nicholls because we were English. Work that one out. And then they went, well, neither of you are like really like good commentators. And then about 2 days after that, Jack Nicholls then got picked up by Motors TV, and then we giggled quite a lot. So...
The guys they've got at the moment, they're just atrocious.
Ah, but they're American. Well, I don't know, I've not actually watched it. Oh, smack!
Oh,
is that Kevin Stern?
It wasn't a pit stop.
He needs a pit.
He's obviously a fan of the American commentators over on iRacing. Outraged by my comment, drove straight into a wall out of frustration.
Yeah, how dare you! Kamikaze! But yeah, I'm not...
Andreas Loeffler did just take over that car as well.
Oh, yeah. He has, hasn't he?
They forgot to repair the damage done.
Whoops.
Repair the damage?
Well, no, but they
what
can
a shame.
Miss.
They get encountered by aliens because bad news travels fast.
They miss literally everything that goes on. They just read off lap times through the whole... It's dull as hell. Absolutely boring.
I think also they are quite stringently told exactly what they can and can't do by the people that obviously run, because it's all I was ever told when I was doing it was, this is a promotion for iRacing, you've got to basically say how fantastic it is, and I really didn't get on with the game well at all. So when they was asking me to talk about things to do with the game, I got really angry with it. I just wanted to talk about the racing at hand and make slightly rude jokes as well. Waffler, Loffler, Loffler, in too deep. He's somehow got it back going again, as that's Mirlovold there just unlapping himself, but...
What?
Mirlovold? I won't say Meatloaf.
Mirlovold.
It's Mirlovold, isn't it?
Yeah.
Pinky. Ole Marais Mirlovold.
Pinky.
Oh, yeah. I won't say Meatloaf. But yeah, it was one of those things that I think you're very, very stringently told exactly what you can and can't do. Ooh. To the point where it's become sterile. And, well, watch out, because Stefan Pearson there is about to be caught up in Loffler taking the car off the track.
Sorry.
We're not watching where the good juicy bits. We should go back to Andreas. Okay, no problem. Sorry, I wasn't complaining or anything. I appreciate all your hard work.
It looks like Loffler's got a flat tire at the front as well.
Yeah, this is the wall quite large.
Yeah,
but someone's got some brown marks on his nose as well.
Well, I don't. That's just me doing my rimming technique.
God!
That's understeer.
Oh, it's blimmin' rude.
No, I was going to say, I've just hit a clanger, and then I thought, the clangers! Does anyone remember those? Actually, I do have a story about hitting... No, actually, should we not say about hitting the clanger, to be fair?
Do I wait until the stream is finished?
Something else nowadays.
Okay, we'll have. You know how we have, like, Hollyoaks has like the late night version.
Yes.
We should go off air and then just have our like own late night chat version, where just no holds barred even. But here comes Kevin into Andreas Loffler into the pits. I nearly mated the two of them there.
Don't use the term mated, honestly.
What? More co-joined.
Oh, but we need a name for it, because you could have it, see, it's like the Late Show, and then we... Well, you had Elvis and the Jordanaires, didn't you? You could have Simon and the Pubic Hairs or something.
Simon and Pubes. Better than Simon and the Crabs, I suppose.
Simon and the Clangers.
As long as you all go. Simon the Moomin.
We get Elvin to do that bit. He's good at doing things like that.
Yeah. Very talented man.
Yeah, guys, you let me do that.
Okay. You can that can be his guest slot, but he doesn't do anything else for the rest
but
of the show.
If we do it, we need to get the bloke who does the voiceover on the X Factor. To introduce it, because he sounds like it's some sort of scary movie, doesn't he?
Tonight,
the bloke off the lot, because it sounds like he's always about to wet himself every time a ball comes up, and he's been doing it for about 17 years.
It's almost as if he doesn't know what's going to happen next, isn't
oh,
it? Really?
Of course he doesn't really
know. It's the lottery.
Ticket.
If he knew, he'd be richer.
No, but what it is, you wait one day, he's going to get a lottery ticket, and every day they go 35. Hang on a minute.
Oh dear. Well, with 7 minutes left, guys, should we try to summarise the race?
Yeah. Well, it's been well good, isn't it?
We'll wait 7 minutes if we'll come on the list.
Yeah, not necessarily, since the broadcast crashed.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. There's only that amount of time to go, it should be a run down to the end, maybe.
Okay.
It takes so long to switch the cars, but we should start now. Maybe we're done by tomorrow.
Tomorrow has already come.
Yeah,
that's
next
not good.
Tomorrow.
Oh, okay. They say what's always coming but never gets here, tomorrow.
Tomorrow!
Old people in the bedroom
come.
Also.
I was going to say, if You're always looking at... Right, I don't know, actually, I'll finish that.
It's like
that.
Always never let
it for yourself.
Okay.
You never see horses with peasants.
It's because they're all...
No sense. Have you ever seen a gift horse? How would they wrap it up for a start? You've got no opposing thumbs.
Well, I have seen a clover's horse though, and it did look quite pretty. Petr Kaza is leading at the moment. Kazar. Kazar! Kabam!
Kazar.
But it's Petr Kaza. That's how it looks.
Do you know what? I'm not Essex and that. Do you know, like, not even bother, like, chamming? Oh my god.
Oh god, don't even get started on Essex. Not in an offensive way, but that's
how it's
going to I've been on Essex. Oh, John Davis is not quite facing the right way in P2, and he's left himself splattered across the track, actually. He's left himself going. No, he's back going again. So, Petr Kaza.
Replay.
Okay, let's take a little replay.
He's gone on the track.
That's not what happened. He went straight on.
Oh.
Oh dear.
Good job.
Well, they didn't head up in the barriers there.
You're doing it wrong.
He was a 17-year-old.
Boo. Okay, so for a quick rundown of the order, now that we're in the last couple of minutes, Petr Kaza leads and is pretty comfortable with a 2-minute margin for Torrent Motorsports over John Davies second for Atlantic Racing. Come on. Third is Jan Larsen for 05 Motorsports, 3 laps adrift, 217 laps completed. Fourth is Dennis Porogniak for Akuri Sim Motorsports, also 3 laps adrift, and that's not entirely finished, that, because we just need to make sure that no one else is pitting again. Stefan Persson is 5th for Atlantic Racing Team, 8 laps adrift, all on his Larry. 6th, and there he is on your screen, Enis Doughty to bring in the car home for R4R Motorsports, 10 laps adrift and leading the P2 category. Second in the P2 category is Simco Hungarian Team, currently run by Tilla Kish, who's done a good 6 laps all on his own, so I don't know if people just haven't turned up, or they've just gone and checked what he's doing rather well, let's just let him get on with it. Either way, he's done a good job. 8th, Eddie Holgren for ME Racing, 14 laps adrift, 206 completed, 3rd overall in the P2 class, solid effort indeed. 4th in the P2 class is Andreas Loffler, just coming back. And Rickard Helson just poked me to say Dave Carr Smith's going to take over the car. Sorry, mate, it's quite funny. 205 laps completed for Black Rebels, 15 laps adrift. Carl Middleton is 10th for Total Sim Racing, 202 laps completed, 18 down from the leader, and very much on his own there. But still doing good. Big up for you, Wayne and co. Ole Marius Meervold, 11th for RMI Motorsport. Go, Roy. 197 laps completed, 23 down, very much leading the second gaggle of cars. David Gronvall was for SRH Zeno, has gone against all odds and still kept going, 24 laps adrift, and actually their second half of their race has been much more cleaner than their first, so good on them. Leading the GT2 category, George Talbot, 13th overall for 05 Motorsports, and they've really been cream of the crop for GT2, looking to take 5 out of 5 for that. On the same lap, 32 laps adrift, is Robin Tull. So they have kind of closed back down the rear endurance team a little bit. But it's going to be to no cigar, I feel, for them second overall in the class. Steve Davis for 25 Motorsports is 33 laps adrift. Looking quite juicy, third overall in his class. Fourth in the class of GT2 is Arthur Saizgula for World Connect competition, 34 laps adrift, that means a little bit of pink there, can't beat a bit of pink power when the B&B cars aren't about. Fifth in class, Marcel Vischer for Downforce Racing, 38 laps adrift, and they're slowly being caught by the car behind, but it's too little too late, by Simon Meloish, who is in 18th position, Total Sim Racing, 39 laps adrift. Looking juicy there, Simon Meloish should come home. And last, still running, Kevin Cox for LSC Racing, 42 laps adrift, 179 completed so far. Very big congratulations to him for keeping going and coming home, because it's always good to have. Someone says please go to Jan Larsen, who is in third position. Oh, he's missing his front bumper, that's why. It's all go at the very end. What has happened to Jan? I assume he's buggered it somewhere, but that is going to be potentially a massive problem there, because Denis Porogniak is well within striking distance still. So are we going to have something desperately trying to come to an end here? Can Denis do anything about Porogniak? Because no, not about himself, about Jan Larsen, sorry. But that lost Jan 14 seconds last lap. Ryan's just poked me to say it happened in the Porsche curbs. That's not where he poked me, it was literally where Jan Larsen took place.
He touched me on the curvy bit.
I tell you what, if you've seen my shape of body, there is no straight bits. It's all a curve. I do it for the aerodynamic edge.
It just predicted the start finish straight.
Yeah, there's the replay.
Yeah.
Replay lag, yeah. And Dev Carr-Smith has taken over the Torrent Motorsport car for the last 10 minutes of the race.
He has, although we've got less than 10 minutes left as Dave Carr-Smith takes over the lead. I think he's got literally two or three laps.
We have 40 seconds.
Yeah, so he's Dave Carr-Smith is doing the last two laps of the race. We should get some screen time for the poor man.
We just passed the start-finish line, so it's one more lap done.
Yeah, this is the last lap then. Oh, that's a nice fitting one there, because Dave Carr-Smith's done so well to sit there in the chat room patiently, so it's nice that they've given him the last lap to take over. Well done to Rickard Helston and Petter Kazza, who have really strung the car together. And Dave Carr-Smith,
this is the last lap.
Take it home.
So the time will finish on this lap.
It will, the timer has gone.
Oh, there we go.
So this is the first time ever. Richard Blocker is jumping up and down in the chat room saying that Toll doesn't have to pit, so that must be everything. Rickard Helsen's put, we want DCS. So there we go, they are showing him the love. And we should show him a bit of love too. Everyone loves DCS. He's very much a mainstay for sim racing as a whole and does a lot for the community, so it's nice to see him get to take the chequered flag. Also, he is the man that gave me the PC I am speaking from today, since I asked him to custom build it for me because I hadn't a bloody clue what I was doing. So thank God for him. John Davies.
Oh, go on.
No, go for it.
I was just going to say, seeing as it's the end of the race, I just wanted to take a chance to thank both my teams for getting the car home in one piece. It's been a fantastic season and I couldn't have done it without them. There you go.
Aww, group hugs. I couldn't have done this season without Joachim and Roy and George. For all.
And Yuri.
And Yuri. And everyone else.
And Sanger.
Get Jose coming in and saying things like, Simon, you twat. You've got to click the on button. Yeah. You've got to click the on button. That's me getting slightly aroused and then realising that I'm not actually clicking the right button at all, just to get him back so that he can say it again. But no, it's been an absolute pleasure commentating on all of these races with you. And I certainly look forward to the 24-hour... which surely must be a world record. We need to sit and sort something out with that. It needs to go down. And DCS there, just tentatively lapping Doughty. Next up is Eddie Holgren. They're keeping him on his toes around this last few laps. Corners.
Remember, we want drivers in there to speak with.
Of course. All drivers are welcome, of course, for the end, because we will have a little shindigaroo. Last couple of corners then, and 12 hours in the making. Dave Carr-Smith takes the win for Torrent Motorsports for the P1 category. Just behind there was Enos Doughty taking the P2 category win for R4R Motorsports. Fantastic drive there by Torrent Motorsport, who went against adversity to make sure that he's got that. Pitch. Here is the battle for third. Is it Jan Larsen? No, sorry.
It's the Atlantic horse, I think.
Okay, yeah, John Davis.
They're going to go for a synchronised finish, aren't they?
Oh, how very
camp. They keep it on the track.
Yeah, unless they were always hoping more teams do, but whether they do or not, I don't know.
Very swish, but yeah, Tyrant Motorsports have won that. Just looking,
they are doing.
Robin Toll is... Why is George Talbot not shown as... Ah, okay, George Talbot is going to come through for 05 Motorsports to win the GT2. He's got a little way yet left to go. As the drivers cross over. So Tyrant Motorsports win then. John Davies for Atlantic Racing is going to be second. 05 Motorsports 3rd, Akuri Sim Motorsport 4, Atlantic Racing will be 5th when they cross the line, and that's all of your P1 categories. P2 has got R4R Motorsports winning that one from Cinco Hungarian team. ME Racing will take 3rd. The Black Rebels will be 4th in that category, followed by Total Sim Racing 5th. There he is crossing the line now, actually. RMI Motorsport 6th. Woo! SRH Xeno M7 in that category. And the GT2 class, George Talbot will win for 05 Motorsports, indeed he already has. Rare Endurance team will be second, 25 Motorsports will be third, World Connect Competition will be fourth, with Downforce Racing 5th, Total Sim Racing 6th, and LSD Racing will be 7th. In that class, 19th of the 19 finishers and 42 laps adrift. So we're all home. We just got just Andreas Loffler and our two Sires Gula left to go. And once they're across the line, everyone is done. So, an absolutely classic 12 hours of Le Mans. We had some fantastic batters.
You've been eating fish and chips again.
Battle, sorry.
No, he had an Indian.
No.
That's another story also for another day.
Oh, 24 hours day coming up soon, there'll be plenty of time.
Yeah. We'll have to cope with the off-topic bits in that. 24 hours is quite a while.
Yeah, and I think the good part is the watershed goes from 9 to, 6 the next day, just thinking the trouble we're going to get in.
I tell you what, for that one, I will be properly tank-drivingly drinking so that we can just be disgusting. And then I probably won't be allowed on air again afterwards, but never mind. All the drivers are now home.
And the drivers are driving us, so we speak.
And just congratulations from me from all the finishers, and congratulations to all the non-finishers for doing what you did as well. I think, you know, shows dedication to the league that most of us have made every round.
Yeah.
You know, great commentary team, great league admin. Thanks the race department for allowing us to make a mockery of their live broadcast, having races and everything. I think it's another season that's just expanded on what the RDMS set out to do in the first place. Bigger and bigger.
So, Simon, should we start with the interviews?
Well, let's indeed start with the interviews, and let's start with our P1 winners. And that's Tyrant Motorsports, and I can already see in here we have Rickard Helston.
Oh, yes.
Congratulations, well done for a fantastic win. Talk us through it, because you in particular had some quite juicy hair-raising moments, but you managed to fight through it.
Yeah, I had to give you guys some exciting moments.
part of the service.
Yeah, exactly. No, actually it got a bit messed up in the first stint. I got Petter's steering lock, so I had like 17, I think. Normally I drive with 12. Got a bit juicy at the beginning. Then came the small mistakes, and the small mistake led to a big one. And we lost like 2 minutes, so good we had the lead anyway.
And you managed to get back up to practically a 2-minute advantage by the end of the race, regardless. But, yeah, good recoveries all round. And also we've got Petter Kazza in for Torrent Motorsport as well. Of course, you've done quite a share of the line's work yourself, and but not quite so many dramas as Rickard.
No, but actually I had two spins, so wasn't that undramatic.
But obviously lots of pressure early on in the race, but he was able to pull through and do some good manoeuvres, I think, as well. So.
Yeah, actually, I had a nice fight with Bilaka, I think it was, in the start of the race. I was actually a bit faster, but the problem was that he got always the slipstream, so I never got a clean lap, actually. So, Jan Larsen and Peter Ennis pulled away from us.
Okay. Well, no, it's done very well, and of course you both handed over to Dave Carr-Smith to do the last couple of laps, because he waited very, very patiently. I'm assuming, well, Rickard did pop in the chat box, "We want Dave," so showing the love. Nice to see you all go home.
He was actually going to do 3 hours, but when I screwed up, we decided that me and Petter stayed in the car.
So he gets 3 laps. Bit of a downgrade.
It was up to him, actually. He decided.
Ah, well, not too bad. It's still a team effort, of course, throughout. And your team boss also finishing for another team further down the order. It can't have been bad at all. So, looking good for the 24 hours one, then, surely?
Yeah, I think so. We also must thank Borna Spoliarz for his awesome engineering on TeamSpeak. His own words.
Okay. Or is he just shouting and swearing at you all?
Yeah, pretty much.
Excellent. That is the Borna we all know. And love, bracket. So yeah, no, congratulations, well done. Also...
Thank you.
Hey. Also, we have in here... Is that... Let's go for fourth. Placed man Dennis Porogniak, whose name I have butchered. I do apologise, Dennis. Just missing out on the P1 podium there.
Oh, that was something, really. Hello, everyone. That was really close. I was like running like my. I'm sorry. I nearly killed someone just like 2 laps before the end. I'm really sorry about that. Just flew past in 4 chicanes like an idiot. Wow. I was like qualifying for the last hour or something.
But it kept you on your toes. It kept us on our toes as well, because we wasn't quite sure of the strategies, exactly how everything was going to work out. So great for you to, well, not great for you to miss out on the podium, but it did keep us amused. And then Jan Larsen went and lost half of his car at the end there. I've just seen him join actually in the chat room, so we'll get to Jan in a bit. But
that
dangling
was the
carrot.
When I pushed the boost button like crazy and thought, okay, this is the chance.
But it was good to have 4 teams that were really out in front, pulling away and dominating the race in effect, so it was great to see. Puts you in good stead, of course, for the 24-hour race if you're going to take part.
Yep. We're going to take part.
Good stuff. That's what I like to see. And just chatting to Jan Larsen now, in who took that third place podium. What happened at the end there? You kept us all in shock.
Yeah, blame it on George. Nah, I just lost the concentration there because George keeps talking.
Yeah.
Our race was compromised from the start when we started crashing. About 12 crashes later, and we're still in third. Can't complain.
Oh dear. Oh well, never mind. At least you know that the car was well put together. That's all we'll say for that.
Not really.
A number of times.
You saw that on the broadcast.
Yeah, they were good at putting it back together. Just didn't stay on the car.
I even had a game of chicken with the fuel tank near the end. I had 2 litres coming over the cross finish line. Good thing I crashed, I wouldn't have crossed it.
Never mind. But well
done for a good podium and a solid result nonetheless. Jumping down to the bottom of this room here, we've got Wilfried van der Brink, who of course helped secure 5 out of 5 victories for the GT2 class, taking the mick, aren't you?
Yeah, it was a good season for us in the GT2 class. Yeah, like you said, 5 wins. So, yeah, we cannot complain, and we won the championship in the GT2, so...
Didn't fancy sharing the wins out then.
Yeah, well, my teammates George and Kevin, yeah, they didn't want to win this race, I think.
It's all George.
They kept crashing the car.
We tried our best to make it more interesting, but somehow we still won. The car was pretty battered, but yeah.
So yeah, George, your attempts to lose the race were foiled by Wilfried's excellent driving. Well, you had some scary moments.
Well, it was quite funny. Like, we normally have a driving plan where everyone does like 3 stints or whatever, so people know when to plan their day. But today sort of just went out the window because I think I ended up getting in the car twice. Wilfried drove the car twice. Kevin drove the car twice. So yeah, it was completely unplanned. But yeah, somehow we didn't have any issues with driver swaps, so a boo-hoo to everyone that says it doesn't work, but it does. And yeah, just happy to take the win. I'm sure if any other team had probably pitted a few times less than us, they could have had a chance of winning today, but yeah, we'll take it.
Super duper. That's what we like to hear. And the other winners, of course, were the P2 categories. And we've got Brendan Kaczmarek in the chat room representing those. Congratulations, Brendan. Talk us through it.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, it was all right. A bit up and down.
That was a bit of a down car.
How many cars finished without knocking a splitter off? Hands up, guys. I don't see anybody.
I think there was a Porsche.
No, we managed not to knock ours off as well.
You're lucky. You are in the minority. We knocked it off at least once of my own doing on an outlap. I ran 2 totally flawless stints and then hooked it on the curb exiting Touch of Rouge on my outlap, tore the splitter off, and did the rest of the stint sans front downforce. And it was fine. It was great. Came in, fixed the damage, did another stint. So I did a quadruple, handed over to Ennis. He took it, and didn't really have any major issues. And then we got to have some fun. We got to go up against the Simcoe Hungarian guys, and they caught us. We led from the first lap up until about lap 150 when they decided they wanted to lead instead. And we battled about 3 seconds apart for a couple of laps, and they decided they wanted to play some games. So I figured, well, 2 can play your games, and... a couple of drafting battles down the Mulsanne later, managed to pressure him into a spin exiting the Mulsanne corner. And it was pretty clear sailing from then on out. Perfect last 5 hours, no incidents for us, no splitters gone. So nice to bookend the season with wins, 1 at Sebring, 1 now, a couple of podiums, and a championship, which is pretty cool.
Loving that. Well done. Congratulations.
Unfortunately, it wasn't quite so good for our team car. The debut for our Massive. And it didn't work out for them. They didn't get to finish. But
Massive failed.
Good effort anyway.
Not to worry. Just now I've spotted him in the room itself. Second over in the P1 class, John Davies. You had some eventful moments during that race. Notably a quick spin on the very last lap as well. Talk us through it, because it was a near miss for you today.
Yeah, I'll keep it brief, because I need to sleep, because I'm just shattered. I don't know why, but the car felt shit for most of the race, so can't really say much more than that. Made a lot of mistakes, but we got to practice a little driver swap, which was fun. And that was it, really.
Good stuff. Well, congratulations on the second position. It may sound like the most deflated second place I've ever heard in my entire life.
No one sounds happy to be on the podium today.
No, do you know what? Let's just hand it out to everyone else. Never mind. But no, congratulations, John, and I'm sure you'll be back for the 24 hours, where hopefully your car doesn't feel like a shambolic piece of shoddy work.
It's past the watershed, some of you may have noticed, so, you know, you probably can get away with it.
Never mind.
We went past the watershed for 5 hours.
Yeah.
And made full benefit of that.
I tell you what, there's not a lot I don't do with benefits, so it's all good. Who else have we got in here? Robin Toll, second place, I believe, for rare endurance in the GT2 class. Well done.
Well, thank you. We had a great race. A few minor setbacks from my part. I had a few accidents. One you actually showed on the live stream, I guess, if I'm not mistaken.
Possibly.
Yeah, maybe. I'm not proud of it, but we made it, mostly thanks to Richard Blocker. And, it was really fun for us. And we're very happy to finally finish a race.
Yes, because you've had so much bad luck with your problems over the years. Not years, the year, rather.
Yeah, the year, yes.
It's been well overdue. You deserved a finish. So, well done indeed.
And finally a second place.
Yes.
Feels like a win.
Well, you did some good fuel saving at the end.
It was really exciting.
Yeah, we were trying to push you because we weren't sure when you were going to pit, so Steve tried to really push.
Yeah.
But then he needed to save fuel. So, yeah.
Well, it was very close. I crossed the finish line with only 1 liter of fuel left. So I was my entire stint saving fuel. We knew this from the start, so that's why I was going slow the entire stint. This was fun.
Finally, someone happy to be on the podium.
Yay!
Just being given the win.
Well, aside from you're happy to be on the podium, George, surely?
I'm pretty happy. I'm pleased that it's sort of ended on a high. I think I predicted 20, didn't I, to finish?
Yeah,
and I think 19, so that's a pretty good effort for a 12-hour race. So, congratulations to all the finishers, and now I can relax for a bit.
Absolutely.
And I'll check my inbox tomorrow morning when you all complain.
Well, we do like a protest. And of course, you're moving on to pastures new, like a cow that's eaten all the cud on the grass. It's, you're moving on.
We're not 100% sure yet. There's plans in place for season 4. You don't really know who's going to be running it, but I can pretty much guarantee there will be another R Factor 1 RTLMS season, and it won't be too far away. So who's running it, I don't know. But yeah, I can guarantee that.
Good stuff. Well, is there anyone else in here that would like to say something? We've got Stefan Persons in here as well. Quick word before we sign off, Stefan.
Oh, a great series and a very well done event. Want to thank you, the organizers, George, and the rest of the guys behind all this. All your hard work really gave us a great championship. And also big congrats to our sister car who made a championship. That's it. I'm tired. I want to go to bed.
Fair enough. And yeah. Last word also from Simon Mellowish, since you've been sitting there patiently waiting. Any last words for you? Nah. That sounds of it then.
This is Sparta!
He's cooked out. So, Joachim Roy, anything you'd like to add? It's been a pleasure.
It's been a great season.
Absolutely, and we're all looking forward for the 24-hour race.
Yeah.
Which is going to be 31st of March, I believe, isn't it?
Yeah. Just quickly, before we switch off for season 3, I'd just like to say a big thanks to Simon Smith, Joachim, and Roy. They've done a great job with the broadcast. Everyone else who's chipped in with the broadcast too. You know, you've really added to the series. Also, a big thanks to Yuri, who's done a lot of work behind the scenes that you don't often see. And yeah, it's been a nice setup and a nice partnership, and thanks for all contributing. And yeah, hopefully the RTLMS continues to develop and we have an even better season 4.
Here's to that. Well, I think that's about time for us then to sign off and say doodle pip. It's been an absolute pleasure. I'll just...
We are the champions.
My friends. Sounds good. Sounds good. From, on behalf of George, Joachim, Roy and myself, this is the end then of season 3 of RDLMS. It's been an absolute pleasure from start to finish, and I look forward to seeing you on simrace.tv soon for more high-octane action from the